Hey there, and welcome to another edition of Tour Confidential. I'm Ryan Aselton, and I'm delighted to be joined this week by Golf.com's Josh Berhau. And joining us from the sunny desert out in Arizona via Skype is Golf.com's Jessica Marksbury. And guys, Jason Day finds himself back in the winner's circle as he wins the Wells Fargo Championship, holding off Aaron Wise and Nick Watney late, coming down the green mile there at Quail Hollow. The second win of the year for Jason Day. And Josh, this is a player who used to be world number one back in February of 2016, was the last time he was number one. Disappeared basically in 2017, had injuries and family issues, but now two wins this season, and he's talking about getting back to number one. Does Jay Day have the game to get back to that top spot?
He absolutely has the game. It's not going to happen overnight. He's got some ground to make up now, but he's an enormous talent when he's healthy and when he's clicking. You look back to 2015 and 2016, he had 5 wins in 15, 3 wins in 16, a PGA championship, a Players. That 2-year span is like a fantastic career that any PGA Tour pro would gladly take. And he just, when we had that big three conversation a few years ago, it was always Jordan Spieth, it was Rory and Jason Day, and our favorite talker was always whose best is the best. And Jason Day was often your answer. And I think he just had to realize that it's one thing to get to number one in the world, it's another thing to stay at number one and sustain that longevity.
Jess, what do you think? We kind of forgot about Jason Day. I mean, Josh mentions he had the 9 wins over a 3-year stretch. This is one of the elite golfers in the world, one of the guys who can really dominate on the PGA Tour, and there's not many that we can say that about. Now, he had a lot going on off the golf course. He seems very focused when you hear some of the quotes about motivation, getting back in the gym, working his tail off. Do you see a continual rise here for Jason Day?
Absolutely. It's interesting, Ryan. I was just thinking about that as Josh was talking. You know, golf is so, what have you done for me lately, right? If you haven't won last week, you're probably not in the conversation this week, unless you're a guy like Rory McIlroy, Jordan Spieth, or Tiger Woods, you know, now that he's back playing competitively again. But I think you all hit the nail on the head. Jason Day is an emotional player. And unfortunately, he's been a bit fragile physically over the last several years. So dealing with the injuries, dealing with the things that have been going on in his family, it's been really difficult for him to compete at the highest level, at least over the past year and a half, maybe even 2 years. So seeing him back in the mix now, as Josh said, he has all the tools. I mean, the guy he smokes it off the tee. He's got a great short game. And we know that when the mental focus is there 100%, hey, this guy's friends with Tiger. He's getting some tips from Tiger throughout his whole career. And I'm sure he's getting maybe even a little bit of a mental boost seeing Tiger in the field now, being able to play alongside him. So definitely see a lot of wonderful things to come for Jason Day. It's great to see him back. It's exciting to watch.
Yeah, he also talked about getting that text from Tiger over the weekend on Saturday saying, go get it on Sunday. So they are tight. No question, the game is there. Josh, what do you think about the emotional side? This is a guy on the course. I mean, right now he's number one in strokes gained putting. His short game is phenomenal. But he talked about having doubts yesterday. He didn't play great golf yesterday. He finished strong, obviously, 16, 17, 18, but he kind of hit the ball all over the golf course and had doubts about saying, oh, no, I'm losing this thing. Is that surprising for a guy who is a major champion and a former number one?
You know, I think it is a little surprising for him because he doesn't seem to have the scar tissue that Jordan Spieth, Rory McIlroy, some of these other guys who've had these big-time collapses. He hasn't really gained that, or he hasn't really had to suffer that yet on tour. So I think it speaks volumes to what he can do when he's hitting driver all over and he hits one in the water on the back nine and he's still able to go birdie, birdie, and then up and down for par on the last to win.
Jess, what do you think about what he's got going on off the course? It seems like things have settled down. He has 2 kids, another one on the way. Tiger even talked about Jason Day being in a different stage of his life, which is now a new stage of his career. Do you think that he has that a little more in balance now?
Absolutely. There's very few players, I think, that can really separate the emotional, family stuff that's going on at home and just compartmentalize that and go out and play golf. I mean, it just tends to be tied together when you're suffering a little bit when it comes to your family and things going on around you in your personal life. You usually see that manifest itself on the golf course. I mean, we see that time and time again, right? With Sergio Garcia, we would always say, gosh, if he's happy, right, he's playing great. And I think to a great extent there with Jason Day as well, now that things are really lining up and calming down a little bit, he has the ability to focus just on his golf and make that the best that it can be. The less distractions that there are from the outside, the better it's going to be on the golf course. And, you know, things, it's great to hear that they're expecting another baby. I know there was a lot to deal with there with Ellie's miscarriage last year. So great things happening for the Day family. And, you know, it's always nice to see the nice guys do well. And Jason Day is certainly one of the nicest guys out there.
Yeah, Jason Day now heads after a win to the Players' Championship, where he has won as well, a former champion there. But we mentioned Tiger. We got to talk about the pairing. Jess, let's start with you. Tiger set to play with Phil Mickelson on Thursday at the Players' Championship. The hypometer is through the roof this week down there at TPC Sawgrass. First time since the 2014 PGA that they're paired together in an event. Of course, they played together in a practice round at the Masters this year. Had a lot of fun out there. What do you think? Tiger, Phil, with Ricky Fowler as well. But Tiger and Phil here, who gets more motivation going into this week playing together on Thursday?
Yeah, it's rare when Ricky Fowler is like third billing, right, in a pairing there. So sorry, Ricky, you're not. Yeah, no one's really talking about you playing in that group. But I'm just wondering what the over-under is on how deep that gallery is going to be, maybe 10, 15 people. I don't know if you're going to be able to get a look in. But in my opinion, Tiger has definitely got to be the guy really motivated here. You know, he's got the most to prove. I've been very bullish on Tour Confidential and throughout the major championships, especially the Masters. I thought Tiger was going to win the thing. It's exciting to see him play well again, but he just really hasn't gotten there yet. And as we saw last week, the putter going cold on him really prevented him from climbing the leaderboard and making a really good showing at Quail Hollow. So Tiger definitely has more to prove. We saw just an amazing round from Phil last week. It seems like he's warming up. You know, Phil's been playing well. So I think this will definitely be motivational for Tiger mostly. He and Phil are competitive. Now that they're buddies, it's even more fun to see them playing well together and, you know, palling around out there like we saw during the Masters practice round. So, yeah, I expect some fun jokes, lots of smiles out there, and it should be a good time.
Josh, it's fun to see the contrast in pictures there. Phil and Tiger, old school Masters. Mm-hmm. Tiger has that death stare on. And then you see their practice round this year. Tiger's smiling. Phil's wearing that terrible shirt. Right. So I hope he doesn't pull that out this week at Sawgrass. But a lot more friendlier pairing than years past. This isn't the Tiger-Phil grudge match that we saw, you know, 10, 15 years ago.
Right. But, you know, you get between the ropes and you're going to have, like, I mean, hundreds of people, thousands of people watching that group. It's going to be insane. And it's almost, you have to play, you're matched up against Tiger, you're matched up against Phil, but it's not match play. You know, you're playing the course. And it's going to be hard, I think, especially to keep those emotions in check. And, you know, everyone wants to compare it. That's what we're doing. But at the same time, you got to play the course. Phil's missed the cut at the Players for the last 5 years. So you can't get too much in your own head. You got to play the course. And if you beat Tiger, you know, great.
Yeah, Tiger, a two-time champ, hasn't played there in a while, but this adds to a lot of fun for what is known around golf as the fifth major. In case you're wondering, they've played together 32 times in their career. Phil holds the edge, 15-14-3. So it's been very tight head-to-head when they have been paired together, and it should be a fun week down there at TPC Sawgrass. Jessica Marksberry, thanks so much for being with us this week. And Josh, of course, thanks to you for joining us. And thanks to you for watching us this week on Tour Confidential. Be sure to join us next week right here on Golf.com.